As Wendy Rogers introduced a bill, it's passed. It is now on Hollywood Hobbs' desk. She may or may not sign it. We don't know what she's doing. And maybe when she gets done with The View, she'll have an opportunity to come back and take a look at what that bill says and decide whether or not she wants to sign that up. Unless she has to do, I don't know, talk soup or something in the meantime. Maybe she has another appointment she can't get to. But is it really a pressing issue in Arizona? So I know some people are saying, like, why are we worried about this? It's a California problem. It's not one of our problems. And it's not like we have a lot of this going on, but it does happen on occasion. So we've got Alan is in Queen Creek. Alan says you're a realtor, so that means maybe you've got some experience with this. What have you run into when it comes to the squatters?
Yeah, my story goes back to 2021, back when the real estate market was really hot. I had a client out of California. He had inherited a home. He was an older gentleman. It inherited a home from his elderly parents who had passed away, and he had reached out to me to help him sell the home. And we start digging into this thing and realizing that there's people occupying the home. I guess they may have had some sort of agreement with his parents who have since passed on, but there was no contract, no written agreement or anything, and just living rent free, not paying any rent or anything, and had been doing it for months and months and months. And my guy wanted to sell the house, and I told him, I said, look, like, you've got to get these people out. There's no way we can sell this house with people in there, especially if they're not paying you rent.
So wait a minute, this guy's in California though. How interested was he in taking the steps that you have to take in order to get somebody booted?
Well, yeah, that's where the education came in. I told him, I said, look, like, we can make this happen. It's not going to be a fast process. But, you know, I can point you in the direction of who you need to contact. There are lawyers here in the Valley that handle this stuff and do a very good job on it. But it took a little coercing, but I eventually got him in touch with these lawyers, and lawyers got him on the right track. But he was a little hesitant at first of taking the next steps. And he's like, hey, we got to sell. I said, yeah, but you got to do some things. Like, we can't just sell this thing. I know you want to sell it, but you got to have people that want to buy it. You got to market it. So
how long did the process take you, Alan, from the first time that this guy contacted you to the time that you were actually able to get them out of the house?
It was a period of almost 3 months. Some of this was a delay on my client's side, but once he got going, you know, again, we went through the legal process with the attorneys and stuff, and we eventually got these people out. But during that process, I mean, even the tenants, because my face and phone number is on the sign, they reach out to me. They say, hey, what can we do? Can we buy it? I said, yeah, you can buy it, but you haven't been paying rent. And I said, at this point, you're going to get kicked out, and this doesn't end well for you.
Oh, really? What were they? Alan, we've been a little bit judgmental about squatters on the program today, so let's just continue in that vein. Did they strike you as the kind of people who are going to be able to come up with the necessary down payment in order to buy the house?
Chris, these are your kind of people. Like, they grew up in probably the part of Michigan where you're from.
Yeah, so, the backwoods.
No, right. These people didn't have the money to buy the house.
Yeah.
No, absolutely not.
I mean, they're squatting, for Pete's sake. If you've got the money to put a down payment down on the house you want, then that's what you do. You don't go squat and live for free, right?
Yeah, this was the type of home. Again, every time you go to the grocery store, you bring the grocery cart back with you.
And it sounds like this was the ideal situation for you as a realtor, too, to be dealing with somebody trying to sell the home and also negotiating with the people who are renting the house, where you got to be a mediator. Alan, isn't that what you sign up for?
Yeah, you try to stay in your lane a little bit, and a lot of those things are out of my control as a realtor. You know, the legal part of it, of getting them evicted and stuff, I really don't have to get too much involved in that. I did, to the extent of I had to probably a little more than I did had this guy been in town. But I took some, I went down there the day that the constable served the people, and we changed the locks and everything. And it's always interesting, having worked in property management prior to real estate. You know, it's never fun when you've got to evict somebody, but
no.
You know, the constable goes down there, they're armed, they've got Kevlar on, you know, they got the vest on, and you got nothing. So you're just hoping.
Oh, that's great.
You're just hoping it's not a bad day for everyone.
Oh, yeah. I love that you got to deal with the constable, too, because rarely do we ever hear about the constable in the news, that we're not talking about London. Ellie, I want to key in on something else that you mentioned here a moment ago.
Yeah.
You mentioned bringing grocery carts home, which, by the way, is a wonderful tool for moving things. How many grocery carts were in the yard when they finally vacated the premises?
Gosh, somewhere between probably 5 and 7. There was quite a few.
That's an entire rack of grocery carts. That's outstanding. Yeah. All right. Well,
yeah, Walmart was missing their groceries.
Yeah, they were. Yeah. All right, buddy. Thanks for ringing us. I appreciate you. Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, thanks, man. Thanks, guys.
Yeah. Valley Realtor there in Allen.
Thanks for watching the Chris and Joe Show. Click to see more from Chris and Joe and tap the button in the middle to subscribe to KTAR News.